temptations. Come lay them down at the foot of the cross. Jesus is waiting. God so loved the world. Bring all your failures. Bring your addictions. Come lay them down at the foot of the cross. Jesus is waiting. God so loved the world. Praise God. Praise God. From whom all blessings flow. Praise Him.
Welcome, everybody. Welcome, welcome, welcome to this house. Welcome to this place. Won't you give God praise tonight for this evening? This is a special evening, this wonderful event that we're going to witness tonight. We are here tonight giving honor and glory to God first, but to honor the icon, the legend, the sister, the auntie, the friend, the everything that she has been to each and every one of you in this room at some point in some time. We're here to honor the LaRue Howard. Come on, let us praise God for her tonight. Woo! Let's praise God for her, all of everything she's sown, every song she's sung, every word she's spoken, every prayer that she's prayed, every hug that she's hugged, every time she listened, every single time. LaRue, we thank you. We honor you tonight. We bless God for you. Yeah. Amen. My name is Anthony Jenkins. This is my wife, Hannah Jenkins. We're going to be coming in and out, MC, and I'm going to be singing a little bit with the choir, you know. But we want you all to just enjoy this evening, bask in this presence and this atmosphere of just love and comfort as we celebrate LaRue tonight.
Giving her flowers while she is here
on this side
of heaven, because she is truly a gift that God has blessed us with. All of the skills, the talents, everything that He has poured into her because He could trust her to give it on to His people. So tonight, we are here to celebrate you, to honor you. And I know it's hard for you to receive all this love, but I want you to receive it because you are deserving of it. And this is just us pouring into you all that you have poured onto us over the greater Orlando area for all these years. So it's an overflow that's coming back to you tonight.
Amen. So without further ado, let us honor a legend tonight. LaRue Howard, won't you stand to your feet? We're gonna start this night with some worship and some praise.
Come on, somebody give God praise for an awesome ministry to this area for so long. If you love the name that Sister LaRue has helped us lift for so long, would you lift it with a hallelujah shout right now? His name is Jesus. He's the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. And my sister has been lifting him for a good while. And that's what we're going to do tonight. Is anybody ready to lift that name with us? Why don't you clap your hands together? Let's do it together. Big sis, we're going to lift the name of Jesus together. Here we go.
Thank you. Let's lift our hands to the mighty God, to the everlasting Father. Lord, you're just worthy, God, and we stand in awe of you. And with this very next song, God, we declare that there's none like you, that no one can compare to you, God. Come on, lift your hands all over the building. Yeah. Yeah. Establish your kingdom, pour your power and your spirit on us now, right now. We need your presence here, Lord. There is none like you, no one compares to you. All the things you've done, establish your kingdom, pour your power and your spirit on us now. Right now, we need your presence here, Lord. For Lord, you are holy, you are worthy, you are almighty. Lord, you are holy, you are worthy, yeah, you are almighty. right there in the presence of our Almighty King. Oh, ya la la la, ya la la la, ya la la la, ya la la la.
All right, give God praise right there. Come on, give God praise. He's worthy. He's worthy. I know you feel that energy. It is charged in this atmosphere. The Lord is present. He is here. Hallelujah. 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 You all may take your seat if you can. Lou, I don't know if you noticed, but surprise. Y'all say, hey. We're getting ready to just continue with the program. There will be a series of videos that we'll be playing. There are some people that echo some sentiments throughout all of the videos that everybody in here probably can say, oh yeah, that's me. Oh yeah, that's me. That's me. That's me. So if I didn't get to you, if you didn't get, that's all right. She's going to hear you in here, and I pray that you hear and feel every sentiment that is spoken. Because you truly made an impact on the lives of God's people. So, amen. Amen. So we're getting ready to have this first video. And then right after that video, followed by, will be Mika King. She'll be right on up. She has something to sing and say to you. Amen. All right. Let's roll it.
Hello, LaRue. I just want to thank you so much. I'm actually in Vegas, and I came in the skeleton experiment, and what do I see about breath? So we all breathe the same air. You taught me so much about how to breathe, and when people ask me what the most important thing in life is, I answer, just breathe. So I'm excited to know you, and I thank you for just all that you taught me with the Vocal Athlete course. You are a phenomenal human being, and I wish you so well on all your endeavors. This is Willene. I am a vocal athlete.
So my name is Teresa Davis, and I am in Delaware. I had the pleasure of meeting LaRue over the last few months. She is just a beautiful, wonderful person inside and out. And it was such a pleasure to meet her, get to know her a little bit, and to be under her tutelage. And so I just wanted to say that I'm thankful for God putting her in my life. And because of her, I am a vocal athlete.
Hi, Ms. LaRue. This is Emanuela. I bless the name of the Lord for connecting us in such a divine way. Though I have not known you for that long, I feel like I've known you for ages through our conversations. And that's because you have such a beautiful soul. Your personality is very contagious. What I admire about you the most is your love for God. It is very empowering and very encouraging. I wish you well on your journey ahead and your future endeavors. I pray that the Lord will continue to bless you, sustain you, lead you, guide you, protect you, provide for you, and do many, many things according to his riches.
LaRue, let me just say that I love you. I'm so grateful for God. He is so good because it was by divine appointment that he has brought you into my life. I was on the verge of just dropping out of frontline because I was like, I haven't been singing in a long time and I need like some techniques, I need some skills. And you instilled that, you poured into me. And I just want to tell you, thank you. I love you so much. You know, and I pray that God just blesses you continuously with you and your family. So thank you so much once again, and blessings to you. Love you.
Praise the Lord, everybody. Are y'all tired already? Praise the Lord, everybody. We are here to honor my friend tonight. Oh, y'all can stop the track because I'm going to talk first. Yeah, I'm going to talk first. Mika King, ladies and gentlemen. LaRue,
goodness gracious. I'm so excited, but in this excitement, I cannot lie. My heart is so very sad that my sister is not going to be just right down the street from me. When I refer to this woman, I refer to her as my best friend. And I fight a couple of people for that title. It's all right, because when it's me and her, I win. But the title that I don't fight for is sister. She is my sister in the natural and in the spirit. And if you know anything about this woman, you know that she can get a prayer through to our God. Amen. We have known each other for so long. I will never forget. I met LaRue. I don't even know if you remember this. I met LaRue. We were both singing at an event. I believe it was at Disney. And she was with the choir, and I was with some background singers, and we were doing separate things. But I just remember when the group that she got up with sang, she just stood out to me. Anybody know she stands out? She just stood out to me, and Cece Winans is one of my favorite singers. And she reminded me so much of her. And I remember going up to her and being like, "You remind me of Cece Winans." And that was a wrap. We were friends from that day. And we have prayed together. We have cried together. We have laughed together. I will also never forget when we were both working, you know, the real jobs, as they say. And we just wanted to be singers. That's all we wanted to do. We just wanted to sing. And both of us went to an audition at Universal Studios. And after the audition, we just had a sister girlfriend talk. And this was before we were as close as we are now. We were still in the beginning stages of our friendship. But I remember us, and this was in the year 2000, when we were 10. I remember us praying in my car that God would open doors for us so that we could leave those jobs and do what we both felt we were created to do. And if you look at the fruit now, you know that every single one of those prayers that were prayed in that car were answered. Amen. And we are all better for it. I've been singing with this woman for, I can't even count the years. I don't even know how long it's been. But we've sung on each other's albums from the first one to now. I'm on all of them. Okay, and when you make another one, I'm coming to Chicago. So, you know, tell the new people good night. And she is a person who opens doors for others. I remember when I saw Martha Munizzi in concert. I went back to LaRue and I said, "I love that lady. I want to sing with her." And she went and told her about me, and then that started a 10-year journey with singing with Martha. So she opened that door for me, and she taught me so much that I know now about leading worship, commanding the presence of God, and ushering people into his presence. All of that, I watched you, I learned from you, and I'm just so grateful for the friendship that we have. So grateful for you being my sister, and when it's just us, my best friend. Amen. Oh, I did that and I didn't cry. Yes! So now we're gonna give thanks. Amen. You remember this one? Girl, I know you're not up in the club. Come on, everybody, stand where you are.
Praise the Lord, praise the Lord, praise the Lord, praise the Lord. That's good. Come on, give God praise. Y'all, please excuse this raggedy paper I got in my hand. This does not represent the excellence of the church, nor Ralph. But it's long. I don't know what's coming up. I gotta remember. That's all right. I got these classes and everything. I gotta look at it. All right, choir, you all can go ahead. Y'all can have a seat really quick. We're gonna have another video. This video is it's another sentiment. Memories, impact, favorite song, favorite memory. This is from the mouths of these people here. I called it the tribute in memories. So after the tribute in memories, we will have the choir. We will come back up and we'll be singing Defender, which was written by LaRue, Ed, yeah. And Alisa will be leading that. Amen. All right, let's roll this video.
LaRue has impacted my life in so many ways, so many countless ways. My most precious memories started when my very first day at Faith World, I was going into the foyer, and she came and she smiled this big old smile and said, hi. I didn't know who she was, but she just made me feel so good being, you know, coming from a small island and coming to this big church, and somebody actually smiled and said hi to me, only to find her go into the sanctuary, and there she was singing and leading praise and worship. That was like the best thing. And from that day on, she became a mama and I became her big baby. We are going to miss you so much, Mama LaRue. I cannot tell you how much I love you. Well, I've been telling you every time I talk to you, but you're gonna be surely missed. But I know this is not the end for us. This is just a continuation, because when I am ready, I'm going to be calling you, hopefully not midnight. I love you, Mama Ru. I really do.
My favorite song, most people may not have heard of it because she's done so many, but for me, it's The Essence of Your Presence. When I first heard that song, I have to tell you, from the moment I heard it, it totally transcended me to where I was able to be with the 420 elders casting crowns at Jesus' feet. That song allowed me to just partake in what is to come. And for that, that just made such a difference for me. And it's one of those little hidden treasures, that's what I call it, songs, because a lot of people, when I've mentioned it, they haven't heard of it. So all I can say is, take a moment to listen to The Essence of Your Presence. You're gonna be blessed. LaRue, I love you. We all love you. And you've been so special to us, and you're going to be missed.
So my fondest memory, one of them, of LaRue is when we were preparing for the Christmas production, our annual Christmas production, and we were preparing the night that Christ was born. And she was trying to get us to learn how to sing this one particular part, and she referenced the movie. And you're going to laugh, because the movie was Trolls. And she was talking about, I think it's Princess Bridget, and trying to get us how to tell a story. And I'll never forget that moment. And I'd never seen Trolls, but I went home and watched it, and I can sing the ooh, ooh, and the ah, 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 and tell a story. So that's my fondest memory of LaRue.
My favorite songs that LaRue sings, I would have to say, would be her hymnals. LaRue does an amazing job with the hymnals. I mean, every time she sings them, just it breaks me down literally into worship, especially the Alpha and Omega. You are Alpha and Omega. They worship you, our Lord. You are. Oh my God, I go into like the ugly cry, like, you know, when she's singing that song. And I just love the hymnals that she brings forth during our time of service, so our time of worship. Thank you, LaRue. I love you.
I've been singing in choirs
since I was about 12 years old. I have never, ever had my parts sent to me to a song. And when I joined the choir at River of Life, LaRue sent us our songs in our parts. And so when we got to rehearsal, everybody was familiar with the song and they sang in their parts. That's the spirit of excellence that I have learned being under her leadership. She is an amazing person, and now I'm a better choir member because I understand what it takes to be in a choir. I love that she takes scripture and turns it into songs. So it's been an extreme pleasure to work with someone of that stature and to really be impacted. When I go places, now I understand what I'm supposed to do when I'm in a choir. And it took me 20, 30 years to get to a person like LaRue to teach me that.
LaRue, I just want you to know I'm gonna miss you so much. I have one particular moment that you really impacted my life that I will never forget. I came in for rehearsal one Sunday morning, very heavy-hearted. I had some issues going on with my son, and I was just not myself. And I came, you know, you called me in the office. We sat down and talked. You related to what I was, you know, what I was going through. You hugged me, and it felt so genuine. You hugged me, you prayed with me, and then we went out in the rehearsal area, and you had all the choir members. To, you know, we spoke around and we all got together and they all prayed for my son. I just want you to know that really made an impact on me. And I just want to thank you. I want you to know I love you so much. Even when I miss church and watch it online, your voice, I mean, God really bless you with an angelical voice. It's like it feeds my spirit through the TV. I'm just so glad God allowed our paths to cross. I love you, sis. I wish you all the best. Now I got a reason to come to Chicago. I love you, sis.
So I've had so many memories with LaRue Howard, starting with Faith World. My one that I recall the most is having to sing for her for the very first time. I was very, very nervous, and she helped me to relax, and she helped me to find my voice. And make sure I know that it's okay. And just her always loving on me, always asking about my family, asking how I'm doing, making sure I'm okay. The best memories. I have many favorite songs, many, many memories that I can keep for years to come.
LaRue has made a massive impact on my life. Just being who she is, you would think that for somebody of that stature, she is LaRue, you know? But in reality, she is this down-to-earth, easy-to-talk-to person that you can always, you know, if I have any issues or anything, can always go and talk to her. And that just shows me how humble she is and so powerful in her ministry. And being someone who has been ministering for years and years and years, I look at the example that LaRue has given in preparation of ministry. It's not just going out there and just singing, but you have to prepare yourself, be ready spiritually, be ready vocally to go out and do your thing.
Who can find a virtuous woman? Her price is far above rubies. LaRue, I'm going to miss you. I'm going to say it first. When I first came from the islands and I entered the church, I was like, who is that creature with that beautiful sound coming out of her? And I was so blessed by the entire worship because I did worship in my church on the island of St. Kitts. So I was like, oh my God, who is she? I'm so blessed. And then when I decided, I talked to Shondell, I said, I'm going to join the choir, I want to be part of it. And I came and you were just such a warm person, you were so loving. I mean, you had patience with us, you're just the best. I don't have words to describe the kind of person you are. You are a Proverbs 31 woman, and I'm going to miss you.
Luru, I just want to say I love you. I appreciate you in all that you do in the choir and as individual, me personally. I just want to share what you have done for me in my singing, being on the praise team, and also doing the choir. For one thing, the way that you would teach us in terms of our breathing technique, and me applying that, what you call technique there, as I want to just tell you how it had blessed me personally in my singing, especially hitting those high notes. And when you do need to breathe and take a pause and so forth and so on. So I want to just tell you personally how your presence there in the choir is truly, truly, truly not only respected, but will be missed. I mean, I personally will miss you. And I just want to tell you I love you, appreciate you and all that you do here at the River. And I know that the Lord has and will do great things in and through you in this new journey that you're about to embark upon. So I just want to tell you that your tenure here at the River, especially in the choir, has greatly been appreciated by me personally. And the way you have taught me, the way you've definitely, what you call, outpour everything that you know in me. And I just want to let you know that I appreciate you, love you. Now, I'm not going to try to cry here, but I just want to let you know I love you. Appreciate you, sis. Love you.
LaRue Howard has impacted me with her genuine heart, her genuine spirit. She will see you come in on a Sunday or even rehearsal, and it's almost as if she can see into your soul, but she doesn't make it obvious that she's seeing you. Then you randomly get a text in the night or the very next day to be like, hey, yeah, that's what she would say. Just checking on you, just seeing if you're doing okay. And sometimes someone seeing you and just asking if you're okay, it can go 1,000 miles. So I appreciate that part of her. Not just being like, I have a lot of other people, my own issues I have to deal with, but more being mindful and also concerned about those around her to make sure that they are okay as well. So, LaRue, I appreciate you for that, and I'll miss you to pieces.
Knowing LaRue going on 10 years now has been very impactful. I met her fresh out of high school. I watched her in Faith World and on YouTube for a couple years before I met her in person. And then just meeting her and like feeling her spirit, how sweet she is, how down to earth, it was like an automatic draw. And I asked her to be my mentor. First ever, I had the unction to like, I need to be under this lady. And everything she's taught me and guided me through up until literally today, it's been so impactful, and I feel like I can take it with me for years to come. I know when I'm down, when I'm out, I can call her like literally at 3 a.m. I'm about to make a dumb decision. Please, what can I do? And she will pray for me. She will sit with me, and she would just really give me wisdom and godly knowledge. And I'm forever grateful for LaRue because she stuck with me for life. Okay. Period.
Yes.
to celebrate you tonight, LaRue. I thought the best thing that I could share tonight would be the words that Dr. Faith proclaimed over your life about 5 years ago in Tampa after you had ministered in an event. She shared with you publicly that a worship school would be coming out of you where sons and daughters can be taught their identity. She said, sons and daughters will come out of you. She said, your husband is a father too. But she said, there are sons and daughters that are coming that have been hurt and been abused. She said, and they will confide in you and find refuge in you. She said, this is a season of roots being planted deep and going into different states and nations. She said, there has been a season of obscurity, but the Lord says, I am getting ready to rebirth you, and I am not done with you yet. And she closed that time of encouragement with this final statement. She said, God, we bless you for this mother. And I think that every person in this place tonight, every person that is watching via live stream, every person that desired to be there and honors you and celebrates your life would echo that same sentiment, that God, we bless you for this mother. For this mother who has taught us to love and to cherish and treasure the presence of God. You have been a mother, and I am grateful, so grateful to God for you.
Hey, Auntie Cousin Rue, JP, John Pope, and I can call you Auntie Cousin. Listen, I was and am so excited to hear about your new assignment in Chicago. It sounds like it's gonna be wonderful. For you and for your family, and I know that you're excited as well. It's sad to hear that you're leaving the Central Florida area, but if anybody knows how that goes, I definitely understand, and I know that you'll be doing Kingdom wherever it is that you'll be. So my best to you on your journey in Chicago and in your next phase of life, and I wish I could have been there tonight to be with you and to celebrate you and to honor you for being just a beacon and a gem in the Central Florida community for so long as I can really remember. Thank you for all that you've done for our area, for our community, for the artists in the areas, for giving us opportunities, for giving us workshops and showing us the way and teaching us, training us on how to try to be as good as you. But thank you for all that you are, all that you've done. We're going to miss you for sure. God bless you. I love you, lady. Blessings on you and your family. You take care.
Hey, LaRue, Marvette, and Parker. On behalf of the Moors, we are without Taisha tonight. She sends her love, but we just wanted to tell you how excited we are that you all have this next season of life in Chicago. Boys, anything you want to say to Parker?
Yes, I would like to say that, Parker, we had a really nice time as a friendship, and our friendship is not over, and that even though you're in Chicago, it didn't stop us from being friends.
Yep, I second that. That was great. Couldn't say it any better.
So we declare just over your family that as you head into this new season, that the Lord will bless you and keep you, let his face shine upon you, lift up his countenance to you, and give you great peace. And he places his name on you. Congratulations on this new season. And thank you, LaRue, for serving and impacting City Place Church the way you've done over the last 7 years and the friendship that you've all provided our family over the last 20. Congratulations.
Hey, LaRue, we are so happy for you. You know, when Pastor Liz told me about this awesome opportunity, I thought back to a moment, a glimpse of glory when you were here with us. And I'll never forget, me and Liz talk about it. Donnie McClurkin, the godfather of soul, come on, came in the office and said, LaRue, singing, LaRue, LaRue, LaRue. Many people have a voice that they think is for the world, but they only have a voice for a house. Mm-hmm. And he said these words, I'll never forget them. He said, but you, my dear, have a voice for the world. We are so proud of you and your accomplishments and where God has opened doors and what God is going to do with your life. And we celebrate you. We're excited for you. And congratulations. And you will be a blessing to the people of the world, as usual. And we love you.
And we're so excited. I just echo what Pastor Chris said. That's what I was going to say. So he said
I got to go first.
But
sorry.
He got to go first. So, but LaRue, we really just love you so much. We've been so grateful for the relationship with you over the years. You've been such a blessing to our house, to me personally. And I'm so excited for you as you begin this new journey, as you begin this new chapter in your life. And I believe that the greatest things are yet to come for you, and we are so excited to be able to kind of watch and see what God does through you and with you in this next season. We love you so much. Congratulations.
Hey, this is Javen, Pastor Javen Now Church, and I want to say a very special congratulations to my friend Dr. Minister LaRue. I love you. God bless you. We're excited for this new season in your life. You know, consistency, faithfulness, and a heart of worship to me is the best compliment you can give anybody. And that, my friend, you have. It's been a joy to watch you from afar and up close, ministering with you both on recordings as well as in live services. And just that consistency, that gentleness, that humility, and that heart of worship has always been there throughout the years. I know God's getting ready to blow your mind in this next season. We congratulate you on behalf of Now Church and the Now family here in Hollywood, Florida, and myself. We say congratulations. We love you.
LaRue, my poor little heart. I took the time to write you a message, so I'm going to read it to you now. I just want to tell you how much I'm going to miss you. Words are not enough. It's been an honor to serve with you. You've been a spiritual leader in my life. Many times God has used you to deliver a word or a song when I needed it the most. I can't write this without my eyes filling with tears. You've been a sister and a friend. We've laughed and cried together. I love you so much. I've watched you as mom and wife serve in ministry so gracefully. I'm no good with saying goodbye, so I'll say see you later. I'm praying for you as you begin this new journey. I can't wait to see all that the Lord has in store as you continue to reach the world through worship. I love you, sis.
Pastor LaRue, I remember the day we sat in your office and you appointed me to oversee the dance ministry at Faith World, and I literally gave you every excuse, including my Episcopalian upbringing, but you weren't having it. You said, Terry, God is calling you. It's your time. And you know you were right. And through him, coupled with your love and your encouragement, Vision Dance Ministry was birthed. Wow. Thank you, Pastor LaRue. Thank you for being a great example of living a life of faith. You have blessed us with your voice of an angel in your praise and worship. So may the blessings of the Lord continue to rest on you and your beautiful family. I love you, and may the peace of the Lord be always, always with you. God bless.
LaRue, Mama, Big Sis, yo, I have to tell you, I'm just so excited for you. I know that everything you're walking into now is a product of all these seeds that you have sown. You have sown by far the most seeds in Orlando, Florida. And we are, I can speak for pretty much every worship leader, worship pastor, worship team member, we are your fruit, big time. You are an anchor in every way, and you have anchored so many of us over and over again. And so, yes, though Orlando is losing quite a piece to the puzzle, the Lord makes great sense out of all things. And baby, let me tell you, in this season, the transitioning of all the things is like chess pieces that he's about to checkmate on all of us. And so I'm excited to know that your yes is allowing you to be a part of that. It is just the right time, and I'm just so proud of you. I want you to know that the Lord is with you. You already know this, but I'm telling you anyway, and that I love you. I have your back, whatever you need. I'm so grateful for even how before I stepped foot in Orlando, you saw something in me, and you just grabbed hold of it and made sure that I was looked out for, and you still do to this day, to me and so many others. And so I love you. I'm just so glad and happy. I'm extremely happy for all that God is getting ready to do through you, through your family, through your yes. And so congrats, and we all celebrate you And girl, I can't wait to come visit. I will see you guys really, really soon. Congrats, Big Sis. Love you.
Hey, everybody, this is Pastor Clint Brown, and I am so disappointed I cannot be right there with you. LaRue, I love you. I appreciate you. It's kind of ironic. I'm standing in a hotel in Columbus, Ohio, about to go minister at World Harvest Church for Dominion Camp Meeting, actually the place where I believe, started my ministry. And it's kind of ironic because I believe that Faith World was the same thing for you and did the same thing for you. I am so proud of you. There are two elements in life, in ministry, and one is talent when it comes to praise and worship, and one is anointing. I know a lot of talented people that aren't anointed. I know a lot of anointed people that I wish was more talented, but you encompass both of those. And those two things coming together, allowing you to flow. People don't realize how when you take talent and anointing, you still have to have vision, you still have to have a gift of the prophetic, you still have to be able to lead people, and you have mastered it. You are that person that can take your talent and your anointing and lead us into the throne room. You know, one day my father, my natural father, Charles, took me, and I was telling him, Dad, I'm going to be special. I'm going to be somebody that does something unique. And my daddy took me, and we were working, and he filled up a bucket of water. And he told me, he said, son, put your hand down in that water. And I did, in that bucket. And he said, now pull it out. I pulled it out. He said, where's the hole? And I just kind of looked at it, and he said, that's you. He said, when it comes to music and church and all these things, he said, if you exit, no one will ever know it. You're just a dime a dozen. You're like everybody else. Well, let me tell you something, LaRue. I know this for a fact. In my ministry, and I know and I can guarantee at River of Life, there with Pastor Jackson, that when you exited our ministry, to this day, I still have to go up on that platform at times, look behind me, or I'm sitting on the front row, and I have to go fill the hole that you left. When you exited, we definitely felt your exit. And I know River of Life is going to fill it. Now, God always makes a way and always provides, but you are that type of person. You will always be that type of person. We send you to Chicago with honor, with favor, with prayer. And I know that whatever you touch, their lives are about to change. I appreciate you. I love you. And I thank God that we had you for the time we did. And I pray nothing but the greatest things to come.
Amen. I've been telling LaRue that we not gonna do this. Not today, right? Nope, not today. We not gonna do this. But Hannah was like, "Nah, you gotta say something." So, I'll just share what I just shared with Hannah. This was very important to me, LaRue, tonight, that you hear every word that the lives that you've touched, hear every word, feel every sentiment. As I was just editing the videos, I've already shed my tears, you know, because I was like, wow, you know, from the, it's the globe, LaRue, you see it? It's the globe. You have the globe in your office. It's the globe. It's international. Your impact, literally everything you put your hands to, everything you put your hands to, and that included myself, you know, because LaRue joined the River back in 2013, and I remember Pastor Marvin calling and saying, hey, I'm bringing LaRue on. How you feel? I'm like, what? What I'm gonna say? I was like, that's LaRue Howe, yeah. And I was like, so, he's like, nah, then we go to the office. I don't really know how to move, you know, so I'm like, hey, LaRue. And she's like, you the boss. And I was like, no, I'm not. no, you my boss. And I'm like, I'm your boss. Stop playing. I ain't really believe her until we went somewhere, right? We went to, like, maybe it was a church. She might have been singing with all these different people, celebrity, you know, because LaRue's a celebrity to me at this point. And she's introducing me as her boss. And I'm like, wow, really? And the influence and the impact that you made on my life alone, you know, it speaks through what everyone has been saying. And I didn't really think of anything to say, but I'm really gonna miss my sister. LaRue would get, like, if I call somebody else my sister, who is your sister? Who is that? She know you ain't got no other sisters, Mika. But she got other sisters. I don't have no other sisters. I ain't got no other sisters. But I just want you to know that our family, we love you. And I'm going to pass the mic over to Hannah and let Hannah say something. But we love you.
We've had multiple conversations. But one of the things that I do want to reiterate to you that you've heard so much from everybody is that you just have that mothering spirit. It doesn't matter who the person is, that nurturing spirit that's inside of you is what everybody has had the opportunity to feel when in your presence. And not too many people can have that, because whether you are, you know, biological mother or not, there's just this thing inside of you where you're able to love someone that did not come from you. Not everybody has that ability. And you have shown me how to just love on God's people, because that's what we're called to do. No matter the differences, no matter, you know, whether we go to the same church, whether we hang in the same groups, all of us are God's people, and he told us to love. And you have shown that in your actions, because love is an action. And that's how we know, is by the actions. It's a verb. It's what we do. It's not just what we say. Because you can say a lot of stuff, but how are you walking? You say that even in as a worship leader. How does your walk show the people who you are leading your devotion to God? You talk about being a worship leader on and off the platform. Well, everybody in the videos have testified how off the platform you still ministered to them, because you were concerned about their hearts. It's not anybody can get up on the stage. You know, if you got the talent to sing, you can come up here and sing, but you were concerned about their heart, because it's the true worshipers that will worship, right? So if your heart's not right, then your worship can't be in truth. And you were concerned about that. You didn't let them come up here and just sing on any old kind of way. They shared stories about how when they didn't get the notes right, that you walked off and said, y'all figure out what you're gonna sing tonight. You're not singing that song because you don't have it. And you walked off, and you do it in love. And that's the thing. Like, God, when he has to discipline us, he does it in love, but he'll discipline, right? And so you, LaRue, your presence, your love, it's what you authentically have shown us that we are going to miss. That's what's going to be missed. That's the hole. That's the gap, right? Because not anybody can feel that. But it does teach us that if that's how much impact you had on us, ooh, we got to get ourselves right and make sure that we are loving on people like that. So thank you for the gift of your authenticity. Thank you for the gift that God has placed in you. Thank you for saying yes, even in times when you didn't feel like it. Thank you for just being willing and obedient and loving on all of us. And also, you talk about carrying the leader's heart, right? Caring about your pastors. And that's also something that I have learned from you, how to care for them, how to pray for them, how to hold them up, even when they don't know that you're praying for them, but you are. So thank you. Thank you for always just teaching me how to be, how to walk this faith out. So I appreciate you for that. You have made such an impact on my family. You've made such an impact on my husband. Thank you again for being his big sister. Thank you for being there for him when his parents passed away. Thank you for just loving on him. I appreciate you. I appreciate you. I can't say it enough.
We thank you for being a standard.
I'm not gonna cry.
Yes,
that's the first thing I'm going to say, because I have to tell myself. First, before I go to the woman we're honoring, I want to give honor to Marvette, to Deanna, to Gabe, to Aaron, to Parker. You guys sacrificed a lot. Deanna, I knew when you was little, I won't say like little, but before you had a family, I knew you sacrificed a lot so she can be who she is. Marvette, you've stood by her from day one. Thank you for allowing her to be who she is. But this move is not just about her, it's about all of y'all, and y'all are going to grow, y'all are going to flourish. This move is not just a move that is going to allow LaRue to be LaRue, it's gonna be a move to allow Marvette to be Marvette, for Deanna, for Gabe, for all of y'all to be who you are, so thank you, thank you. You right here, thank you. For number one, making me an honorary choir member, thank you. Appreciate that. That's not my ministry, but I appreciate it. But seriously, thank you for being there for us. You married us. You've watched us grow. You've watched us mature as adults, as a wife and a husband. You've given me so many pointers of being a good wife, but not just verbally. I've watched you be a good wife to Marvette. And you're the example in all things, not just in ministry, but in life, because you're the same person on stage that you're off. And that's rare, because people kind of act different when they're on the platform, but you're the same. Like, you will correct somebody in a loving way, but you'll also laugh. You'll command God's presence when it's necessary. And I love that about you. You allow freedom for all of us to minister in a way that is our truth. You give us that freedom. You give me and my sisters plenty of opportunities to minister in our truth. And so I want to say thank you. Thank you and thank you.
All right. So, as a musician, I don't normally speak very much. I'm very comfortable behind the scenes. Very, very comfortable behind the scenes. And, Rue, you have pulled some stuff out of me that I didn't know I had in me. And I appreciate you for that. Marv, I definitely honor you, bro, because when we met, you know, we were just kids, man, 20, 21 years old, trying to figure out life, going to school, trying to figure it out, you know? And you allowed me the opportunity, me and my girlfriend at the time, my wife now, the opportunity to get close to you guys and to see you guys for who you are, which is the same. You've been the same, both of you. You've been highly consistent. And guys, I believe that there are two different types of leaders, man. There's a good leader that knows how to push the right buttons to get the best out of you. They know how to know exactly which button to push and how long to lay on it, right? But then there are great leaders who live their life in such a way that the example creates a pull for you to want to be more like them. That is who you are. That is who you are, you know? I'd never dreamed that I would have the opportunity to, you know, serve along someone of your caliber and of your heart, your spirit. You know, I never dreamed that I would have the opportunity to produce music and travel the world in ministry with you, with people like you on your level. But you embraced me, you know, You let me be free and be creative. You send me these crazy voice notes. And she'd be like, go crazy, go figure it out, make it happen. What? Okay, all right. You know, and I mean, you're gonna be missed because you allowed us to do some crazy stuff just to be creative and foster the ministry gifts that we have. And we appreciate it, you know, definitely appreciate it. And man, I could just, there's so much I could say, but when we were walking through and we started the journey of walking through one of the toughest seasons of our life, trying to figure it out, I called you. I called my mom and I called you. And you prayed. You prayed, you cried with me, you prayed. You cried me, you prayed. Hugged me. Always told me it'd be all right. And it's been all right. And now you're being promoted to the next level because your branches truly have reached over the wall. And now it's time for more people to be exposed to the gift that you are. So, we don't take this moment for granted, but we honor you. We honor the Howard family. Didi, I love you, girl. You were so small when we met. That's crazy. Now you got a little one of your own. It's crazy, man. There's so much growth that has happened, and we honor you for real. Because you really, truly, like, the room is full, but there are so many more people who wish they could have been here. You know, there's so many videos that we didn't get to put in because we didn't have time. When we posted the message on Facebook, I had people from across the water, from Barbados and from Bahamas and Germany, and people were hitting me up. Hey, what's happening? Where's she going, huh? Because you've made an impact that spans the world. And now it's time for more people to see it. So we bless you. Thank you for being who you are. Thank you for serving the way you do, in spite of your own stuff, in spite of your own journeys and stuff that you're walking through. You put all that to the side to lead us in worship, to create an atmosphere and an environment where people can encounter God's presence. And it flows beyond the four walls of the church. I mean, singing at Festival of Lion King at Disney, like I told you on Monday, like there's something that you hold, there's an anointing that you hold. It don't matter what you're singing. Circle of Life make people cry. Like, Circle of Life make me cry. Like, not gonna lie. Because there is a weightiness, there is an anointing, there's the hand of God is on your voice and on your life. And everywhere you go, you take it with you. So we appreciate you for fostering and stewarding those gifts and just being who you are, because you are loved and you will be greatly missed. But
sure, we'll go with that. One last thing. You have overcome so many challenges. Like, some people don't know everything that you've gone through, but you have overcome so much. Now is your time. It is your time. Embrace it. Enjoy it, because you didn't go through all of that for nothing. And the things that you had to overcome, I know some things have already started to show, but there's so much more that's coming because you overcame way back here. Those were just seeds that you planted. And it's encouraging because we've sown some seeds as well. And so, not if, but when we have children, amen.
Amen.
When they come, they gon' know Auntie Rue's voice. They gon' know Uncle Mar's voice. So, y'all be back.
We love you.
Love you.
Bless God, bless God. Woo, breath that off. Everybody say, woo. Woo, yes, Lord, yes, Lord. All right, so next, we are going to have another icon in the building, Martha Menenzi. She's going to come up. She's gonna say a few words to you, LaRue, and she's probably going to sing something too. And then right after that, we have a little surprise that LaRue probably doesn't know about, but she'll be surprised when we say it.
Thank you so much. Hold on. Let me get to where I'm supposed to go first. I am just so glad to be here. Hey, everybody. It's just amazing. It's incredible. I have so much to say because I'm just overwhelmed in this room watching what's happening. You know, it's incredible to me. I'm not going to preach, but turn in your Bibles to... No, I'm kidding. Hey, choir. You know, it's incredible to me to be the age that I am, which I am... Thank you. And to see this many years that have gone by, and there's not a lot of people that you know that you could say, I knew them when. I knew them before. All y'all knew them. And I can say that about LaRue. She can say that about me. And I will never forget that time in Apopka, Florida at Faith World. She came into our church and we had been praying, God, please send us some really good singers that can sing all the parts. We had some flashy singers, but we didn't have like good altos and tenors and y'all, you know what I'm saying? And all the alto singing tenor, y'all know how that goes. And I remember she came over and I said, we're doing an audition, and she auditioned. And we did the audition, I believe, after church. And I was just blown away because all my prayers had been answered. Because here is this girl. She wasn't even a woman yet. We were both girls. And she could sing all the parts. Like without even breathing, without even thinking, she could just sing alto, soprano, mezzo, soprano, everything. Like four part, whatever you needed, she could sing it on the spot with no one else singing along. She could sing it. She had the ear of the gods. I mean, it was just incredible, her ability. And so I remember, I'm gonna tell the story, Larissa. Okay, I'm gonna tell the story. Okay, because you tell it. And she was so incredible. And I remember Pastor Brown, you saw him a few minutes ago. He came out, big hands on his hips. Who is that? Just looking. We were so excited. And then after the audition, I don't think we saw you for a few weeks. And we were so excited. We're like, this is it. This girl is going to be it. And she just disappeared. And I was so disappointed. I'm like, what in the world? That was before cell phones. I didn't know how to make a phone call without, you know, a cell phone. But I couldn't find her. I didn't know where she was. And I remember one time Pastor Brown comes out a few weeks later. He said, where is that girl that could sing all the parts? I said, I don't know. We need to pray for her because she fell off the planet. We need her back. She was mine. I need her. And within, I think, a few days later, week or two later, oh, it was the same day. You're right. That same day, she comes walking up to me after church, and there she was, all in her glowing. I was like, there she is. And she came up to me and said, I want to apologize. I don't know what happened. I just feel like the enemy just kind of attacked my mind, and it was just like another level. I didn't know what to say. And she said, I just didn't come back. I'm like, what? I said, well, you better come back because we've been looking for you. We've been asking for you. And from that moment on, we laughed about that moment several times after that, about how the enemy, as he's taking you to another level, as God is taking you to another level, the enemy will just try to resist that and bring fear and bring intimidation or whatever it is. And I am so grateful that she fought beyond that. She was young. We were a little girl. We were little children, little babies. And she pushed beyond it, and she became a right hand to me while I was a worship leader there for many years. And then God began to transition me out, and then she was right there. And I don't think Pastor Brown would think that I left a hole because you filled it. And not only did you fill it, you took it beyond. And then you went from there to where you are now. And can I just say to the pastors of this house, I am just so honored. The way that you're honoring her is tremendous. It's a model of how you should be able to do it. To have a night where we just sit here and honor someone who's leaving our church. Pastors don't do that. They usually have you slip out in the middle of the night. They don't want anybody to know and hope you don't notice. Am I right? And to know that there is this environment and this platform and this celebration for you speaks volumes of your pastors and leaders. Yeah. Volumes. Yeah. You should stand for them. This is an amazing house of honor and celebration. We often hear about honoring our pastors, but your pastors know how to honor the people. And that is an amazing example. And LaRue, you are a model of how leaders should be, the way you've raised up sons and daughters. You've raised up sons and daughters. And that's how it's done. If you want to be like her, you've got to stretch, you've got to grow, you've got to be willing to lay it all down and raise sons and daughters. You are her sons and daughters. But you know what I love? Couple things real quick. I'm going to sing in just a second. But my song is short, so I can talk long. Okay, so we were at the Dove Awards together and nominated at the same time. And I remember sitting in that beautiful room. I think it was the Grand Ole Opry or wherever it was at the time. And we were so excited. And she was nominated for Song of the Year. I was nominated for something else. But I think my award was towards the end or something. And when they announced her name, that she won the Dove, I was just beyond. I felt like that's my family, that's my sister, that's my girl. Look at what God is doing. And I remember, I'll never forget her walking down with this look of just overwhelm, but humility, like, Lord, this is happening. Thank you, Jesus. And then that night I won. So we won the same night. So we have just had some incredible experiences together over the years. And I know that God is moving you from here, but the way that you're leaving and the way that you are being sent is really what this is. You're being sent. And God is sending you. You didn't just get a bigger opportunity. No, God is sending you. And as I'm sitting there and I'm hearing all these incredible voices speak and people say how they feel about you, I just heard the Lord say, you are a type of a bridge. But I don't like that word bridge, because it's kind of like, I don't like that word. It's not a big enough word for what God is doing and what God is doing for your family. It's not just you. Again, I agree that it's your whole family, that God is moving you to a place to not just be a bridge, but an overpass, to be a highway, to be a builder of something, a connector. And when you begin to look at what a bridge is, an overpass is, a highway is, it just makes a mode of travel that much faster. And so that says to me, God's accelerating you and he's moving you into a place that he's going to connect people from all kinds of backgrounds, walks of life. And I believe there's going to be healing of the nations right where God has you. Is going to heal us. Racial divisions, God's going to heal. He's going to use you, because he can trust you, and he's taking you to a very significant place. It's a place where it's been waiting, it's been growing and building for you, for your family to be there. So this is an assignment, and you're being sent. You're being sent. And so I don't know what God is going to do, but I'm just believing that you're standing on the shoulders of people who are interceding, praying, believing, who love you, who would die for you. And because of that, God's saying, I can elevate you to the highest places. And I'm in awe of what God's going to do in you. I just get ready for more. And you sang this song so many years ago. Let me make sure I hit all my notes. I think I did. But yes, I did. And I love all the songs that you've written. You're an amazing songwriter. Is she an amazing songwriter? Writing songs for your house, for your church. And I love worship leaders that just pour everything they have right where they are. They're not trying to go somewhere bigger. They're not trying to do, no, there's no other agenda but to pour into the house. And that's what you've done. Wherever God's planted you, that's what you've done. And that's why God can elevate you. And I want to honor you tonight. And I want you to sing with us, because we're going to sing a song that she recorded and won a Dove for. And we're going to sing it together. Can we do it? And let's just worship God. I want us to worship God for what he's done in this time, in this moment, the last 11 years that LaRue has been leading this church. Let's just begin to declare how great our God is. because there's so much more coming for your house. There's so much more that God wants to do in your life and in this church. Come on, you believe that? It's just the beginning of the new day that God is birthing in this house. Come on, let's worship God. Yeah. Let's tell him how great he is. The splendor of the King. The splendor of the King. Clothed in majesty. Let all the earth rejoice. Let all the earth rejoice. That is for
Ladies and gentlemen,
LaRue Howard.
Going to start like saying hey and hi and hi and hey everybody, but I want to just say thank you all so much for tonight. To say that my heart is overwhelmed is an understatement. There's so many faces, so many stories, so many testimonies, so many connections that when I see your face, I know the story. And so I'm so grateful. We're so thankful. How can I say thanks for the things you have done for me? Undeserved, yet you gave to prove your love for me. God, the voices of a million angels could not express my gratitude. All that I am and ever hope to be, I owe it all to thee. To God. Let it point to Calvary. Hallelujah. I gotta acknowledge, had to come prepared. Babe, thank you. Thank you for letting me do what God has called me to do. Because you could have pulled a trump card, you could have pulled an ace card many times and said, no, you can't do that. No, I don't want you to go there. No, you can't talk to this person. No, you could have done that. But you've always covered me and sent me. And so thank you. And I'm excited about what God is going to do in us and through us. It's going to be great. It's going to be great. I love you. To my pastors, Drs. Marvin and Deborah Jackson. I don't even have the words. All I can say is thank you for living a life that has been transparent and that has shown us how to walk this faith walk. Hebrews 13:7, it tells us that we are supposed to honor those and to follow the faith, follow the way that you live your life with following the faith of our leaders. And so thank you for being so open and for being incredible with sharing with us your life story. Pastor D, you talked a little bit about it on Sunday, and I always loved it when you came to the office and we would sit in the conference room and laugh and talk. And distance won't be able to separate us. Distance will not be able to separate us. I'm forever tethered to you. Forever tethered. We love you so much. Thank you. Thank you. To my kids, they're going to forever be my kids. Deanna, Aaron, I know you're watching on live stream. Parker, I don't know if he's gotten here yet. Parker's traveling. And Gabe. You know, in Proverbs 31, it says that her children will rise up and call her blessed. And the flip side to that is that they have to know what being blessed looks like in order for them to call their mother blessed. And that means that they have to have a relationship with the Lord. And so beyond anything else, y'all are here, so y'all standing in proxy for all the others. But beyond everything else, I am so grateful that you have a relationship with the Lord. And that regardless of anything that I say or dad says or your parents say or any other leader says, you know how to get to the throne of God for yourself. And that blesses me. I can sleep better because I know you trust God. I can rest better. Aaron, you're in Atlanta. I can trust God. I can trust and rest better because I know that you know how to get to God. Parker, if you're watching, you're just coming back from PK vacay, spending 4 days in the presence of God, learning about God's word. So proud of you. Cannot wait to see what God does with your life. But I am so blessed. I'm so blessed to be your mother. And I thank you. I love y'all. To my friends and my family, my close friends, I'm not going to start naming names because you know you kind of get in trouble when you start naming names. It's like, why? She didn't say my name. I'm her close friend. My family that's watching in Atlanta and South Carolina and Atlanta. I said Atlanta, didn't I? Everywhere, wherever you're watching from. I love you. Thank you so much for supporting us in this journey that we are going on, that we're continuing. We couldn't do it without your support. So we love you. We thank you so much. River of Life staff. Miss Celia's not here, but Charmaine, Andrea, Adrian, Tanika, Brad, Pastor Dentley, Pastor Blow, Pastor Harris. We did life together. We didn't just work together, but we did life together. We laughed together. We cried. We prayed together. I'm going to miss you guys so much. So grateful, not just for being able to work with you, but also to do life with you and to call you my friends. Love you forever. Worship arts team, band and singers, choir, tech, staging, led by Anthony, Ed, recently Tom. What's up, Tom? And Ryan, man. What I want to leave you is Leviticus chapter 6, verse 12 and 13. Pastor Blow preached this a few years ago about not letting the fire go out. Yeah, nice. So what I want to leave you guys is that you don't let the fire go out. I want to make sure that you understand that you have a responsibility, and I've talked about this, that we have a responsibility to cultivate and to nurture this portal of heaven in the earth that God has given us the responsibility to steward. And the way that we steward that is by making sure that we're putting logs on the fire every day. And that's all of us, not just who's just leading on the platform, not who has a mic, who's playing an instrument. If you're serving in this house, River of Life, we have a responsibility to nurture and to cultivate and to steward the presence of God, this heavenly portal that we have been given right here. And that's what Leviticus chapter 6 talks about. Every day the priest would get up and put logs on the fire, and they would move the offerings around and take the ashes off the altar and making sure that the flame, that the fire of God never goes out. We've been given a charge. You've been given a charge. You can no longer come in and wait for someone to tell you to lift your hands. It's got to start at your house when you first get up in the morning. Yeah? Start putting those logs on the fire before you even get here so you can enter his gates with thanksgiving and come even closer into his courts with praise. Amen? Amen. You said amen, so that means you agree. Faith World Choir. Anybody here from Faith World Choir? Hey, Los, what's up? People, so glad y'all made it tonight. I forever love you, forever. Those kingdom connections, those relationships, man, 20 years later, we're still here. And I'm so glad that we were able to get together, not to view a body, you know what I mean? I'm so thankful that we could get together and love on each other and say we love you and we celebrate. You guys were with me when I was cutting my teeth right after Pastor Martha handed over the reins. I love y'all. Thank you for not leaving when I would fuss at you. Thank you for always loving me back. And it was an incredible time. It was an incredible era, you know. But it's so wonderful to see so many of you going out and doing things that you started during those times when we were together, and now you're walking in the thing that God has called you to, whether it's in church or in the marketplace, you've been anointed for it, and I'm so excited, so thrilled to see you walking in those things. My Disney folks, Festival of the Lion King. Hey, BJ. Man, I'm going to miss you all so much. But I know, you know how this thing works. Paths cross, and I'm just looking forward to seeing you on the other side. and doing some singing together and doing some studio stuff and shows together. Dante, I'm gonna have to come to Paris, but that's okay. We're gonna make it over there. But I love y'all. Thank you so much for loving me and allowing me the space to grow musically. You know, when you do church, you do church. Your focus is ministering to the presence of God and cultivating that whole thing. But when we're in shows, you got to know how to sing, you got to know how to read music, and you got to be able to do some stuff. So thank y'all for pushing me, and thank you for encouraging me and letting me grow musically. I love y'all so much. Thank you. Central Florida, everybody. I moved here when Deanna was 2 months old. We came in, me and her dad, we came in on a U-Haul truck. We didn't know where we was going. She was a little bit younger than Lily. And what a wild ride this has been. But it's been good. It's been 28 years, and I wouldn't have wanted to be any other place in the world. So grateful. I wish I could hug each and every single one of you. I know time won't permit us to do that, but just know that this South Carolina girl, South Carolina Geechee raised girl, will forever, ever, ever, forever call Central Florida her home. And when you see me out doing the thing, doing whatever God is opening the doors for me to do, I want y'all to be able to point and say, hey, that's our girl right there. That's our girl. We love you. Hey, Parker. Nice of you to join us. But we will always call Central Florida home. This will always be home. And wherever we go, we will always carry you in our hearts. We will always carry you in our hearts. And I didn't say anything before, but let me just back for a second. Martha and Danny. Martha, you asked me to lead a song, to lead praise and worship one night when one of the kids were sick. I think somebody was sick. And you called me and you said, I can't make it tonight. The kids have a fever. Can you lead praise and worship? And I was like, sure. She said, don't worry about it. It's going to be okay. Danny's going to be there and he's going to help you and it's going to be all right. It's like three songs. You can sing this song and this song and then sing this song and then it's going to be out. And I said, okay. And I sat down on the side of the bed on my floor and I just cried and I was like, God, please help me. But you trusted me. You saw something in me that I didn't see in myself. And thank you. Because I wouldn't be here. I wouldn't be standing in this place. All of these people wouldn't be standing here if you didn't see that in me. And so thank you for that. My harvest is your harvest. Okay. I love you both. I love you. Apostle Danny and Dr. Precious. Now, many people don't know this, but I would go once a quarter and lead at Women Who Worship at in Leesburg, Florida. And early on, Apostle Danny, you the presence of God just hit and you began to, this was really, really, really long time ago, like before 2011 when I got sick. It was way before that. And you said the same thing that Allison spoke about, that Dr. Frederick had spoken, that there would be a school and that there would be children and that they would be holding on to your skirt tail and they would be gleaning from you and they're gonna be trying to follow you and you're gonna pour into them. And when you saw my post on Facebook, you were like, what? What do you mean? What are you doing? And I said, this is just what you spoke. This is what the Lord spoke through you. So thank you. Thank you. Thank you for calling me to be in that space where you were able to hear God and give me words of wisdom and words of impartation and just bringing clarity to things that I didn't know what was going on, and just brought those things, that those thoughts, like brought clarity to that through the presence of God. Thank you. I love you and I appreciate you and I honor you. Amen. I think that's all. Did I miss anybody? Did I miss anybody? Babe, do you want to say something? No, say something. Marvin, just say something. Say something to the people. Say something.
I'm good.
Dre, you will not win. I just thank all of you. For loving my family, me, my kids, I thank you. We're gonna miss you all. I may not be here sometimes with her, but you all are in my heart. And I love y'all.
I'm gonna turn this back over to Anthony. Pastor Jackson, please give a big welcome to our pastor, the pastor of the River of Life Christian Center of Orlando, Dr. Marvin Jackson.
Why don't you guys put your hands together and let's worship the name of the Lord our God. Make a joyful noise unto him tonight. Hallelujah. There are no other sentiments that I could express that have not already been expressed here tonight. And I think Pastor Clint, he said it better than anybody else, because only a pastor can understand what I'm about to say. There was a prophet in the Bible, and he was trying to get something out, but he couldn't. He said, "The Lord has hidden it from me." And he said this, he said, "Bring me a minstrel." And they brought in a minstrel. And when the minstrel began to sing and to play, God opened up that window. There is a synergy. There is a choreography that exists between a worship leader, a truly anointed worship leader, who's in their set place at the set time in a prophetic house, and you flow back and forth. That worship leader can tell where that pastor is, and it's indescribable. It's hard to explain, but that's what I'm going to miss the most. I'm going to miss that the most. Now, we say we love LaRue. And the Bible says, y'all be seated. The Bible says, give honor to whom honor is due. And so the Lord just put this on my heart tonight. How many of you know that moving is expensive? Moving has never been cheap. Moving is expensive. And so when you say you love somebody, let's express that love with our financial gifts and contributions. And this is a gift, and this offering is an honor for you and the great gift that you've been to the Central Florida community and to so many other lives that you've touched out there in the audience. And the River of Life has a very special envelope that we're going to give to you. And I mean, we got to put something in your pocket, and we're going to do that to try to make this move and this transition a lot easier. Thank you so much. So right now, ushers, please get in place, and let's bless her with our financial gifts and contributions. Is that all right? Yeah. Amen and amen.
Y'all want to sing one more song with me? Okay. Wow. Mm. sure I can see my brother.
unto him who is able to keep us from falling and to present us faultless before his presence with exceeding glory. To the God who declares unto you that I am able to do exceeding abundantly above anything that you could ever ask or think, according to the power that works in you. Until we meet each other again, in the name of the Lord, may God's richest and best be yours. God bless you. Be safe tonight.
LaRue has free product. There's free product out at LaRue's table. She's giving product away to you all as a gift. All right? Amen. Thank you all.